大家好，这里是小镇小民。可能你们有些人知道哈，因为我写了个帖子，我这两天一直没有出视频的原因是我得了新冠。我呢，那个发了两天的烧，非常难受。现在呢好很多了。你们有人给我建议啊，谢谢你们大家。有人给我建议吃那个莲花清瘟胶囊，我有在吃，是感觉好一些了啊。我也有多喝水啊，休息啊什么的，所以现在还可以，但是。嗓子仍然很疼，能够听得出来我的声音是哑的，就主要是一说话，然后有的时候还会咳嗽，所以呢也仍然不能做太久的节目。我呢就想分享一个短的视频啊，那个是我给国内的平台做的，因为我有一期是聊到关于这个俄乌战争在俄罗斯看来呢，它是2014年这个美党它发生的这个，其实在俄罗斯看来是一个政变，西方呢叫它美党革命啊，叫它什么？为了自由民主啊，反正就这些东西。我有这么一期节目，然后这期呢，在那个国内的频道上看的人挺多的，那所以呢，我就说把这个也放上去吧，因为这一段呢是这个 Victor Nuland 的，就是纽兰和当时美国驻乌克兰的大使，他叫 Jeffrey Pryor，他们两个人的一段对话。这一段对话挺有名的，在西方其实传的挺多的。从他这对话里就可以看出呢，他们两个人在那儿商量美党这一个政变结束以后。他们接下来，他们想要谁在乌克兰的政府里？就也就是说，乌克兰啊，它完全不是一个什么独立的国家了。因为他这里头提到这个亚茨，就是叫亚采纽克吧，他后来就是做了乌克兰的总理，他从2014年做到2016年。然后他提到的另外两个人，一个是这个极右派的纳粹党的这个人叫 Tiefenbach，另外一个是叫 Klitschko。这两个人，他说要把这两个人，就是不要让他们进入政府，他们就在外围就可以。那后来这两个人也确实就没有进入政府，就是在外围。所以基本上后来这个形成的乌克兰的政府也差不多跟他们设计的也差不多，就跟这两个人这个对话说到的也差不多。然后他们里头提到，当时那个总统是亚努科维奇，那时候他还没有逃离乌克兰。那后来这个美党结束了以后，他就逃掉了，这亚努科维奇就被他们给颠覆掉了。我放了两张插图，就是相关的人物，你可以看一下。他里头还提到了两个人，一个是 Jeff Feltman 叫费尔特曼，他是联合国的副秘书长，这是个美国人。这个纽兰呢有跟他联系呢，就是说让他找一个等于他们能够接受的一个人。这个人呢给他找到了，就是这个叫 Robert Seary，他是一个荷兰的外交官。那为什么这个人比较重要呢？是因为纽兰说了一个 F 的 EU 这句话呢是特别有名的，很多人都知道。他曾经说过，他为什么要说 FEU 呢？他的意思啊，就是乌克兰这件事情呢，不需要 EU 的人来插手，直接让联合国来，不管是做观察员也好，还是来调解也好，等等来斡旋做什么事情，反正就让联合国出面就好了，不需要 EU 的人。那么他联合国呢，就找到了就是这个人 Robert Seary 这个荷兰人，是 Feltman 是这个美国人推荐的嘛？那他们应该觉得是可以掌控的这个人，说到底就是说要代表美国的意思了。那个时候 EU 呢，可能不像他现在这么好控制了。那个时候，毕竟默克尔还是德国的总理，所以他未必会全心全意的支持整个这件事情，就乌克兰当时发生的 Maidan 这件事情。EU 可能确实很有可能不是很支持这件事情。除此以外，反正骨子里头哈，我觉得像纽兰这样的人，他骨子里头是就是看不上 EU 的。像他们这种西方这种国家，他相信丛林法则哈，他在他眼里 EU 就是靠着美国的。不管你是二战是帮他们打下来的，还是说后面的经济起飞也是用他们的马歇尔计划等等，美国人并不觉得他扶植了这些国家，他自己也得到了好处，这是好像是双方的，他不这么认为的。他骨子里就觉得你欧洲就是很弱的一帮子人，你们自己也不团结，这倒也是了，所以你们就得听我的。那像乌克兰这件事情，他根本连 EU 他都不需要再掺和了，他就直接就找了一个联合国的人来管就完了，就是都不需要 EU 能起任何的作用，所以他就来了一个 F 的 EU 啊，就非常有名的这么一句话，就这么一段对话了，就大家，我就跟大家分享一下，我希望再过一两天吧，能够恢复做视频。反正目前为止，我觉得我已经不发烧了，好很多了。人发烧是很不舒服的，但是我的嗓子确实仍然有。说话多了确实会疼，还有就是咳嗽，所以呢，就暂时先是这样一个状况，好吧。如果喜欢我的节目，麻烦点赞、留言、转发、订阅。接下来你们就看一下这一段他们的对话。好，谢谢大家。
What do you think?
I think we're in play. The Klitschko piece is obviously the complicated electron here, especially the announcement of him as deputy prime minister. And you've seen some of my notes on the troubles in the marriage right now, so we're trying to get a read really fast on where he is on this stuff. But I think your argument to him, which you'll need to make, I think that's the next phone call we want to set up, is exactly the one you made to Yats. And I'm glad you sort of put him on the spot on where he fits in this scenario. And I'm very glad he said what he said in response.
Good. So I don't think Cleach should go into the government. I don't think it's necessary. I don't think it's a good idea.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you think, what in terms of him not going into the government, just let him sort of stay out and do his political homework and stuff. I'm just thinking in terms of sort of the process moving ahead, we want to keep the moderate Democrats together. The problem is going to be Tanibok and his guys. And, you know, I'm sure that's part of what Yanukovych is calculating on all of this.
I think Yats is the guy who's got the economic experience, the governing experience. He's the guy, you know, what he needs is Cleach and Tanibok on the outside. He needs to be talking to them four times a week, you know. I just think Cleach going in, he's going to be at that level working for Yatsenyuk. It's just not going to work.
Yeah, no, I think that's right. Okay, good. Well, do you want us to try to set up a call with him as the next step?
My understanding from that call, but you tell me, was that the big three were going into their own meeting and that Yats was going to offer in that context a three-way, you know, the 3+1 conversation or 3+2 with you. Is that not how you understood it?
No, I mean, that's what he proposed, but I think just knowing the dynamic that's been with them where Klitschko has been the top dog, he's going to take a while to show up for whatever meeting they've got, and he's probably talking to his guys at this point, so I think you reaching out directly to him helps with the personality management among the three, and it gives you also a chance to move fast on all this stuff and put us behind it before they all sit down and he explains why he doesn't like it.
Okay, good. I'm happy. Why don't you reach out to him and see if he wants to talk before or after?
Okay, will do. Thanks.
Okay, I've now written, one more wrinkle for you, Jeff.
Yeah.
I can't remember if I told you this or if I only told Washington this, that when I talked to Jeff Feltman this morning, he had a new name for the UN guy, Robert Seri. Did I write
yeah.
you that this morning?
Yeah,
okay.
I saw that.
He's now gotten both Seri and Ban Ki-moon to agree that Seri could come in Monday or Tuesday.
Okay.
So that would be great, I think, to help glue this thing and have the UN help glue it and, you know, fuck the EU.
No, exactly. And I think we've got to do something to make it stick together because you can be pretty sure that if it does start to gain altitude, the Russians will be working behind the scenes to try to torpedo it. And again, the fact that this is out there right now, I'm still trying to figure out in my mind why Yanukovych did that. But in the meantime, there's a Party of Regions faction meeting going on right now, and I'm sure there's a lively argument going on in that group at this point. But anyway, we could land jelly side up on this one if we move fast. So let me work on Klitschko, and if you can just keep, I think we want to try to get somebody with an international personality to come out here and help to midwife this thing. And then the other issue is some kind of outreach to Yanukovych, but we probably regroup on that tomorrow as we see how things start to fall into place.
So on that piece, Jeff, when I wrote the note, Sullivan's come back to me, VFR, saying you need Biden, and I said probably tomorrow for an attaboy and to get the deets to stick. So
okay.
Biden's willing.
Okay, great.
All right.
Thanks.